Hey, Brooke, what game are we playing today?
Coup!
Sweet! And do you like Coup?
I do.
And why do you like Coup?
Because it's a bluffing game and it's really short.
Short? And how many people can play?
2 to 6.
2 to 6? Sweet. So a bunch of people can get in on it.
Yeah.
Nice. Well, what is Coup all about?
Coup is about killing each other.
Oh, is that all? How do you win in Coup?
You are the last one standing.
Okay. And standing with what? Let me see. What have we got here? We got cards. It's a cards game. Sweet. Well, how do you play Coup?
You play with 2 coins and 2 cards.
That's how you start?
Yes.
Okay, and what are the cards like?
They're influence cards.
Influence cards? Cool.
Yes.
How many different influence cards are in the game?
There are 5 different influence cards.
And 3 of each. Sweet. So everybody randomly gets 2? And
yes.
Then do you put them face up like that?
No.
Okay.
You look at them and you see what you are and you put them down so nobody else can see them.
Nice.
Bluffing.
Okay. All right. Cool. And then on your turn,
do you do? You can take income and just take 1 coin.
Okay.
Take foreign aid and have 2 coins.
You could say, I'm taking foreign aid and grab 2 coins.
Yes.
Okay.
Stage a coup on somebody. And that's if you already have 7 coins in your hand, you can play them in the pile.
Okay.
And then knock one of the person's cards up.
Ooh, and so you knock one of the cards up and reveal it. What happens? What does that mean?
That means that they only have 1 more card to survive.
Okay, so if both cards are flipped over?
You're out.
You're out. And that's what you don't want to have happen. So you got 2 cards, you want to keep them both down. Nice. Otherwise you're knocked out of the game. Okay?
You can do tax and take 3 coins if you are the duke.
So you could say, I've got the duke, I'm taking 3 coins.
Yes. If you're the assassin, you can play 3 coins to knock somebody out.
Ooh, instead of having to wait and pay 7. Okay,
mm-hmm.
So you say, I got the assassin. I'm taking you out.
Yep.
Okay.
If you're the ambassador, you can exchange. You take 2 cards from the deck.
Okay.
And look at all 4 of your cards.
Secretly.
And then, yeah, secretly. And then you keep 2 cards that you want, and you put 2 back.
Shuffled back in. Nice, okay. So then that's how you can change. You could say, okay, I'm the ambassador. I've got the ambassador. I'm going to exchange some cards.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you're the captain, you can steal and take 2 coins from another player.
Nice.
So they don't have 7 coins to kill you with.
Yeah. So you keep them from getting up to 7.
And then if you're the Contessa,
you don't have an action.
Don't have any, but she has a counteraction.
Which
is if she gets assassinated, she can block it.
So you say, Brooke, I'm the assassin, I'm taking you out.
And I can say, I'm the Contessa, and
you can say you're Contessa, so I can't assassinate you. I still pay my 3 coins, but I can't assassinate you.
Yeah.
Oh, but tell me about challenges then.
So, if I say, I'm the Contessa, and then they're like, no, you're not, that's a challenge, and then I would show my card saying that I am the Contessa. And then they lose an influence, so they have to flip one over.
So if someone challenges who you say you got...
If someone loses a challenge, then they have to lose an influence.
Oh, okay. So if I challenge that you're the Contessa and you're not the Contessa?
Yeah, then you...
Then you lost the challenge.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then if I show mine, then I put it back on the deck and shuffle it up and take a new one.
Okay.
So not everybody knows.
So you're... Could have used it and changed it. So cards are continually changing on who you are.
Yes.
People are claiming to be something.
Yeah, you can bluff and say that you're something and not be that thing.
And then they could be challenged.
And then you would lose an influence if you lose the challenge.
Ooh, whether you're a challenger or a challengee, if you lose that challenge. So you got to be good in what you're stating, what you've got, when to change cards.
Yeah.
Is it confusing?
Kind of.
Yeah.
A little bit.
When you first played it, were you confused?
Yes.
Okay. But what do you think of it now?
Now I like it.
Yeah?
Yeah. There are more than just one counteraction.
Okay.
Other than that one.
Okay.
There are, if you are the captain.
Okay.
And they can, you can do stealing, but you can also block stealing.
Oh.
So if somebody tries to steal something, then you're like, you can't do that because I'm the captain, then they can challenge you.
So if someone tries to steal from you because they say, hey, I've got the captain, I'm going to steal 2 coins of you, and you say, ah, I've got the captain, you can't steal 2 coins from me. And then they can say, wait, I'm going to challenge that you're the captain.
Mm-hmm.
So you can challenge at any time. Do you have to be in part of the play to make the challenge?
No.
You can challenge other people when you're not even involved. So everybody's staying alert. Nice. And then it looked like the ambassador as well.
The ambassador can also block stealing.
Okay.
So just not the captain.
Okay.
The assassin can't do anything. The duke can block foreign aid. So if somebody tries to take 2 coins, then they can be like, you can't do that because I'm the duke. Then they'd have to put them back.
Or they could say, I challenge that you got the duke.
Yeah, or you can be like, I challenge you, and then be like, I am the duke. Ha ha.
And they're like, dang, I'm down in influence.
So then they'll have to flip one over. And
And when they flip over, they can choose whichever card they want to flip over.
Yeah, they don't have to, like, put over
the card. Okay, I'm going to choose that one.
They can be like, I don't want this one as much, so I'm going to flip that one over.
And so, is Coup a game where you just play one game and you're done?
No.
How many games do you play in a row?
Have I played in a row? I've played 4 games in a row.
Yeah.
The most.
Yeah. You just keep going. It's like, okay, we got to do that again.
Yeah.
I know how you're bluffing now. Sweet. Well, what would you rate Coup then?
I'd probably rate it a 4.5.
Oh, nice. High recommendation, huh?
Yeah.
All right, let's get our Coup on. Thanks, Brooke.
All right.